For artificial intelligence to evolve into its next phase, artificial general intelligence, we must examine the capabilities and limitations of biological neurons and how these relate to machine learning. In the previous video, we demonstrated how it is impractical to represent numerical values in neurons with precision. Here in part 5 of this series, we cover why the biological neurons can't do the most fundamental process of the artificial perceptron, the summation of inputs.
Future AI. Technologies that think.
Fundamental to all machine learning systems is the idea of the artificial neuron, the perceptron. Let's zoom in on the core function, which sums the weighted signals from the various inputs. Admittedly, there are a few cases where this process appears to work in a biological neuron, but for the majority of cases, it doesn't. Later in this video, I'll show you why a biological neuron using this model will always calculate that 6 plus 1 equals 6. It will calculate that 1 plus 1 equals 2 only some of the time. The biological neuron has a membrane potential, or voltage, which I'll call its charge. The neuron accumulates charge from its input synapses, and the various synapses have weights corresponding to the amount of charge they contribute. When the charge exceeds a threshold, the neuron will fire, sending a neural spike to all the neurons to which it is connected and resetting the internal charge. For convenience, we'll call the resting charge 0 and the threshold level 1. The primary distinction between the biological neuron and the perceptron is that the neuron only emits spikes while the perceptron usually expects inputs to be real numbers. Most machine learning professionals simply say that the perceptron's real number represents the spiking rate of the neuron. In the previous video in this series, I showed why this reasoning leads to neurons which can only represent a small number of distinct values. But the primary issue is that after a neuron fires, it cannot fire again for about 4 milliseconds. The refractory period. During the refractory period, all incoming signals are ignored. Consider a simple example. Imagine that our neurons represent a value from 0 to 10 in a 40 millisecond period, represented by the number of neural spikes emitted in that period. We'll start with a neuron labeled timing, which spikes once every 40 milliseconds, just for reference. To represent a value of 6 in a neuron, we'd have a neuron emitting 6 spikes in the period. Let's assign our signal with a value of 6 to a neuron labeled 6 in this brain simulator simulation and connect it to the neuron labeled out with a synapse weight of 1. So out will fire shortly after 6 fires. Now let's assign another labeled 1 and set it to a value of 1 so it will spike once in every time period, and we'll add a small degree of randomness. For the summation to be accurate, we'd like out to spike 7 times in the time period, but it doesn't work out that way. Looking just at the value of 6 during the 40 millisecond time segment, out will be in its refractory period for 24 milliseconds. So there is a 60% probability that our signal from 1 will arrive during a refractory period and be ignored. If our 1 spike happens to sneak in and cause out to fire, the following spike from 6 will arrive during out's refractory period and be ignored. Therefore, if spikes are evenly distributed, there is no possibility that 6 spikes plus 1 spike will ever equal anything but 6 spikes. If the spikes are randomly distributed, there is some possibility that a neuron might compute that 6 plus 1 equals 7, but the probability is remote and varies with the distribution of spikes. You can get a better summation with neurons if the signal values are small relative to the time period. That way, there is less likelihood of a spike arriving during the refractory period. For example, 1 plus 1 equals 2 will be calculated properly 80% of the time using a 40 millisecond period, and 98% of the time in a 400 millisecond period. But 400 milliseconds is far too slow and too limited to be useful for machine learning. To sum up, the biological neuron's refractory period keeps them from performing even the most fundamental machine learning processes with any degree of accuracy. Further, in the same way that neurons have a limited range of values, as we discussed in the previous video in this series, synapses are even more limited, and that is the topic of the next video. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe to be notified when more videos in this series are available. And for now, watch this interesting video.